Hello friends, welcome to Smart Catalyst. Today we'll be seeing the current affairs of 21st December 2018. The articles we'll be discussing is with respect to prelims. We'll be seeing the 7 articles in detail today. The first article is about Ministry of Commerce startup ranking of all the states in our country. Second one is year in review of Tribal Affairs Ministry. Third article talks about the Technology Upgradation Fund Scheme of India. Fourth article is about the recapitalization of the public sector banks in India. Fifth one is about the new small satellite launch vehicles of ISRO. Sixth article talks about external commercial borrowings. And the final one is about all computers now under government's watch. The first article we'll be seeing is State Startup Ranking 2018. So this article was taken from PIB. So PIB releases year-end review with respect to each and every ministry in our country. So referring all those articles becomes very much important for the prelims exam. So this Startup Ranking 2018 was launched by Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, and this is the first ever state ranking for the startup initiative. We all know that the government has been promoting startup and innovation incubators in India. It has also come forward with 19 point action formula for promoting the startups culture in India from the year 2016. So based on achieving the various parameters in the 19 point action formula formulated by DIP, the states will be ranked accordingly. So some of the key initiatives or the categories which are considered for this ranking include startup policy and implementation, how much incubation support is provided by the state, funding including the initial seed funding for starting up the startups, as well as angel and the venture funding to initiate the startups. It also talks about ease of doing business. Ease of doing business includes simplifying the regulations, easing public procurement norms, and also increasing the awareness to the general public and outreach to the startup industry. So by coming up with this state startup ranking, the state tries to promote competitive federalism. Thereby encouraging healthy competition between the states. So according to this ranking, Gujarat has been awarded as the best performer, followed by Karnataka, Kerala, Odisha and Rajasthan. So there were many states which came newly into the startup framework, like Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. They have been categorized under aspiring category. Northeastern states was also given importance in the beginning category, wherein Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland were forerunners among them. So the key objective of coming up with this exercise is to encourage states and the union territories to take proactive steps to strengthening the startup ecosystem in India. The next article we'll be seeing is year-end review with respect to Ministry of Tribal Affairs. We all know that Tribal Affairs is an important ministry with respect to our exam. So India is a very diverse country. As we all know, India is a very diverse country, and according to Census 2011, tribal population constitute about 7% of India's total population. So protecting this tribal population becomes very much important to safeguard our constitutional ideals of inclusiveness. So in order to empower this tribal community and to bring them into the mainstream society, government has come up with various initiatives, and one such initiative is the recently launched One Dhan scheme. So this One Dhan scheme is a scheme to empower economically the tribal communities of our country. So this is basically a scheme for value addition. So under this scheme, the tribal communities are classified into different self-help groups, and different self-help groups are trained and also provided with the working capital. Thereby, with the proper training and the working capital, it results in human capital development. So these tribals are provided with alternate source of employment, which is a source of economic empowerment. This scheme follows a cluster-based approach, and it also plans to involve big corporates under public-private partnership model to develop the tribal people in India. So here the TRIFED is designated as a nodal agency for implementation of the scheme. which plans to increase the value chain in non-timber forest produce. Presently, non-timber forest produce contributes to only 20% of the total share of tribals. And with the implementation of this scheme, it is proposed to increase to by about 60%. So by increasing the value addition, capacity building as well as skill upgradation of the tribals will increase. So we all know that Forest Rights Act 2006, it empowers the tribal community in our country. According to this act, allows the tribal communities to use minor forest produce which are under non-timber category. So this one then scheme aims to promote this minor forest produce centric livelihood development of tribal gatherers as well as tribal artisans. And currently this MFP or minor forest produce, it is a primary source of income for about 5 crore tribal people in our country. The next article we'll be seeing is Technology Upgradation Fund Scheme, TUFS. This article was also taken from PIB. The Tribal Upgradation Scheme is a scheme from the year 2016 till 2022. And the Textiles Ministry has awarded about 17,000 crore rupees fund for this technology upgradation in the technology sector. This scheme was initially introduced in the year 1999 itself in order to enable technology infusion into the textile sector, thereby making India's textile industry globally competitive, which indirectly will increase India's exports to the global countries. By using technology, this textile sector can be made more efficient, thereby reducing the total capital cost required for the textile industry. This will also increase both directly and indirectly the employment generation, which will definitely help India harnessing its demographic dividend. And textile industry is also one such industry wherein large number of women are employed. So by increasing this technology in the textile industry, it will definitely help India achieve women empowerment. And also its gender equality target under sustainable development goals. This scheme will also help in converting the existing old technology looms to better technology, thus increasing the efficiency, productivity as well as the quality of produce from the textile sector. The next article we'll be seeing is Centre seeks 41,000 crore more to recapitalize bank. This article was taken from the newspaper Hindu. So we all know the public sector banks in India are severely stressed. According to Economic Survey 2018, NPA in the public sector bank stands at about 14%. And 11 out of totally 12 banks which are placed under prompt corrective action framework are public sector banks, that is PSBs. In this perspective, the government has approved additional 41,000 crores to recapitalize the public sector banks. This is above the already budgeted limits of about 65,000 crores. So according to government, this extra capital infusion will help the public sector banks to come out of the PCA framework. And it will also help in the growth of capital for the merged banks. So the government proposes to provide this extra 41,000 fund for recapitalization via supplementary grants. So by utilizing this extra capital infusion, the public sector banks will come out of the prompt corrective action framework, thus providing a pathway for them to provide to expand their credit. Which will indirectly contribute to the positive health of Indian economy. The next article we'll be seeing is Design for Small Satellite Launch Vehicles Ready. This article was also taken from the newspaper Hindu. So ISRO's Vikram Sarabhai Center at Tumba has completed its design for small satellite launch vehicles, which are also called as a baby rocket. So with the increasing importance of digital communication, the satellites which has been released to promote this digital communication has also increased exponentially globally. And from India, ISRO has also launched several digital communication satellites, especially in the low Earth orbit. However, launching satellites to low Earth orbit using heavy satellite launch vehicles that ISRO has, like PSLV, or GSLV becomes economically unviable. So in order to seek a trade-off between technology and the economic extinguisher of the state, ISRO has come up with small satellite launch vehicle. So this small satellite launch vehicle will be especially useful to send smaller satellites like nano satellites, CubeSats, and other technology demonstration satellites, especially to the low Earth orbit. And this satellite launch vehicle can lift off mass up to 120 tons and place 500 kg satellite at about a height of 500 kilometers in the low Earth orbit. This small satellite launch vehicle has three stages, and all three stages are solid stages. And like PSLV and GSLV, this can also launch multiple satellites at single go. But unlike PSLV and GSLV, this small satellite launch vehicle can be assembled both vertically as well as horizontally. The next article we'll be seeing is RBI limits total outstanding external commercial borrowing to 6.5% of GDP. So this article was taken from the newspaper Mint. So what is, for the prelims perspective, one has to know what external commercial borrowing is. So any money that is borrowed from foreign sources for financing the commercial activities in India is called as external commercial borrowing. And this external commercial borrowing is one of the important tools used by Indian corporates to borrow money from the foreign resources at lower rates. And this ECBs are also one of the important sources to diversify the income for the corporates in India. So this external commercial borrowing can be accessed via two routes. One is normal automatic route, and second is via approval route. The sectors such as industrial sector and the infrastructure sector, they are allowed to borrow under automatic route. They do not require the permission of Reserve Bank of India. Whereas other specific sectors such as export and import sector, they have to get explicit permission from the Reserve Bank of India or the Government of India in order to access external commercial borrowing to expand their market. And refinancing of ECBs, they come under the approval route. We all know that Indian economy now suffers from liquidity crisis. And this external commercial borrowing is one important source which can be a solution to this liquidity crisis faced by Indian economy. The next article we'll be seeing is all computers now under government watch. This article was taken from Hindu. So the Ministry of Home Affairs has recently issued an order to authorize 10 central agencies to intercept, monitor, as well as decrypt any information that is stored in any computer in our country. So it includes the information generated, transmitted, as well as received to any internally located computer. So Section 69 of IT Act 2000, it authorizes the central government to access any data in order to protect the sovereignty and integrity of India. So that means that the central government can access any personal data of any individual in the country in order to protect the security of the nation. So using this provision, the Ministry of Home Affairs order, it facilitates to extend all these facilities and the technical assistance to the central government agencies. Thereby, they can intercept, monitor, as well as decrypt the information generated in any computer in India. Failing to do which, it can even attract 7-year imprisonment and even fine. However, this is directly against the fundamental rights which is enshrined in the Constitution via Article 21 of Indian Constitution. Right to privacy is a very important part of this Article 21 of Indian Constitution. So in the Puttaswamy case judgment, in the year 2017, the Supreme Court has opined that any move of the government must pass through the ring test of privacy in order to be considered as constitutional. So unabated intrusion of the state into the private affairs of individual will make Indian state a panopticon.